Well, kind of got my own black flag that I'm wearing here. Somewhat odd and fitting, I know, but looks like we're set to go, so I give you a quick hey yo. Welcome in, everybody. It's the live stream Let's Play. I've been talking about it for a little bit, and here we start up Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag. It's the only Assassin's Creed game that I've played. And, well, it was a free download on the Xbox 360 a good year ago. Or 2 years ago, maybe. I don't even remember. Just loved the shit out of it because of the pirate atmosphere. You know, the getting out on the water, the naval battles that you can have out on the water. Pirates are just fucking cool. Everything nowadays seems to be about... well, about zombie apocalypse and all that shit. And then for that stretch there with Twilight, you had a lot of vampire crap going on. There were two things that I thought needed a lot more love. Pirates, which, of course, the Pirates of the Caribbean movies really bumped that up. And Vikings, which is kind of why I liked Skyrim. But pirates still need more love, in my opinion. Now, as a whole, the storyline of the Assassin's Creed games, I'm not too familiar with the underlying bullshit that's going on. And even the historical references to this game, Templars and Assassins, I know they just don't get along well. That's the gist of what I've understood. Part of this game is, like, takes place in modern time, where there's like a VR machine that you can fucking strap onto your brain or something, and you're reliving the memories of the past of these characters. Something. It's fucking weird. It's almost Matrix-esque. But there's that side bullshit of it. Me, personally, I just like the pirate part of this game. I enjoy the shit out of it. Sweet. I can't quite read the name in the chat there. Hardy. Connor Hardy, if I see that right. Got you there. Welcome so much for checking things in, as I'm just about to start. This is, well, not to say that this is a blind playthrough. I did not finish this game, but I was so damn far into the game. Now, I've mentioned in the past I would consider myself to be a project gamer. This is going to be one of those projects where I'm not saying I'm going to 100% this game, but I'm going to do a lot of shit in this game. Clearing out a lot of areas, finding all the songs, what are they called, chanties, something like that. Trying to find, break in all the warehouses, trying to establish all of the bird's eye view, what, I don't even know what they call that shit anymore. It's been so long. But with that moving forward, I forgot how this game starts. So fuck it, let's just dive in, start this long-term project. Assassin's Creed 4, Black Flag, let's see how this does. Because I kind of forgot. Yes, I want to start a new game, absolutely. Enter name, Cash Money MJL. That is my PlayStation Network gamer tag. Capital C, capital M, capital MJL. Cash Money. Does that show up or is that blurbed out? Nope, that's there. I suppose I'll do that. I mean, that's my PSN name, if you need to check that out. You might want that for future reference. You never know. Link up and play games together online. With me? Really? There's a chance. Now, I know my little face bubble is in the lower left corner of the screen. I don't remember what that might cover up. A radar, perhaps? Put subtitles on for you. If they remaster Skyrim, good question. I don't see it happening.
You see
it might be down the road a bit.
Magnetize!
this way.
Our helmsman's dead! Someone take the wheel!
I'll take the wheel. Oh, Zergal takes the wheel. Okay. Okay, firing cannons. Hold the twos, and the right stick is to aim. Then press... Oh, L2. Okay, so it's kind of... It's like most of your first-person shooters, where one button is to aim, one button is to shoot. Okay, but depending on which way your ship, you have to rotate the camera. You're looking out front, you'll be shooting from that way. You rotate the camera to that side, you're shooting to that side. If you rotate behind you, you get the idea. But that's the idea there. So, let's give that a run. Where'd they go? You have to aim the ship with the left stick as well. Steer it, that is. Easy. Have to take out all these guys? Oh, you motherfucker died. Yeah. Trying to get the control. Because, I played on the Xbox, so I'm trying to remember controls here. We'll sink that son of a bitch, too. Get him. Line him up. Well, that's really hidden back there in the smoke, isn't it? Well, you want some, too, now, huh? Oh, where, come on. Rotate, camera. Rotate. We just missed our shot. Wait for it. And see, you gotta aim a little proper here.
We're ready, sir. Fire!
Fire! God, he's lost in the damn smoke and all that shit. That's a good old boat. I say we sink him. That's tough to see for all this damn smoke and mist. We'll sink his ass. We got him.
Fire!
We don't have the best ship, but we're gonna whoop his ass. You can kind of see the arc, the trajectory of where your cannons go.
Fire! There they go!
Yeah, I don't know what my little face bubble wheel thing is in the way of. So that I might have to change somewhere along the way.
Douse the flames! Get in there, you mongrel!
Oh boy. That's not good. That's an assassin. Whew. Well, damn. See, the first time I played that, I remember I was
dangerous?
Getting my ass kicked.
Oh. Edward.
Hmm?
Privateering, is it dangerous?
Wouldn't pay so nice if it weren't.
Why not sail with the King's Navy? Earn a proper wage, sail under gentlemen.
Sod the Navy's gentlemen. For every shilling I'd earn, the captain gets 600. That's no way to earn a fortune.
We don't need a fortune.
It would help.
It's not about need, Caroline. I want food that don't make me sick. I want walls that hold back the wind. I want a decent life.
Gamble.
How long would you be gone with these privateers?
A year, I reckon. Two at the most.
All right. No more than two. Promise me.
Sure. 2 years of pirating. No problem. Easiest thing in the world. Promise me. He didn't say anything. We just went to a cutscene. Well, this is who we are. That man, Edward. Whose ship just pretty much got sunk to fuck. Yeah, I think, I can just barely see the little bit of the... See that little green dot in front of me? Well, on top of my head here? Yeah, my face is right in front of the damn compass, so, I might need to change where I... Actually, I could probably do that right now. Let me get on shore, and I'll try to do that... Dare I say, not off camera, it just might, slow things down on the recording. Hold R2 to swim faster and to run when you've got your sea legs about you. Right, hold on, let me get up on this. Because I don't know if that's going to trigger a cutscene getting over there. Most of your objectives are going to be just like that. It'll be a little dot on camera And on the dam, yeah, you can kind of see there's little objects and things like this on the compass area. But your objective that you need to reach is obviously there, not just the reach itself, but it'll usually give you distance as well. What you just saw, that 33 meters? You saw the number. Anyway, I'm going to try to reorient my little camera cutout here. I'm going to try to kick it over to the right side and mirror flip this, so one moment, please. This might pause the stream. I know this is terrible, but bear with me, if you can. Broadcast settings. Advanced settings. Camera video settings. Let me go lower right. Boom. Okay, and what kind of effect? Can I flip that thing? Yeah, flip. Wait. Yeah, okay. Flip horizontally. Okay. Hopefully, that's good enough. Okay, that looks good. Now, granted, in this lower corner, see, now that everything's mirrored, it's a little tough to see, but you can see the compass, the radar over there, that's going to help us when we play this game. I just have to remember about going to do that every time I play this specific game. Oh, well. Now let's make our way to the shoreline. And this is a beautiful game. All of a sudden it's sunny out. It was just cloudy as fuck in, like, nighttime. Okay. You're exhausted. Lay down. Throw up a little bit. Paradise. Just don't get shit on. Who's this guy?
Was it good for you as well? Havana. I must get to Havana. Well, I'll just build us another ship, will I? I can pay you. Isn't that the sound you pirates like best? 100 escudos.
Escudos. You'll never insult me with cash.
Keep talking. Will you or won't you?
I heard 100. You can do more. If you're willing to pay 100, you're willing to pay more.
You don't have that gold on you now, do you? Bloody fucking pirates!
Damn, huh? Throw sand in his eyes. Oh, why did... Come on.
I'm on to you, Sneaksby!
Sneaksby. Now we have to chase. Doodle-doo-doo. Doodle-doo-doo. Doodle-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo.
Come on, mate. We're off to a bad start.
Find the assassin. Now, this is another one of those parkour-type games where you're running and jumping and climbing up shit. You can run forever. Unlimited stamina.
It's 100 leagues or more to Havana. Will you walk that distance?
Hoop, climb. I think you just, like, run into things, and then he'll automatically jump and engage and leap and climb. Although jumping, I thought there was a button for that. Is there? Square brings out your swords. X does nothing, circle does nothing. Okay, well, just keep running after him. Whoop, 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 whoop. Now, I think there's an eagle eye. I forgot what they call it. A little area to, you can see it on the radar. It looks like an eagle on the radar. When you get to these areas, and they're usually way up top on something, on top of a bell tower, on top of the church, there's sometimes a bird up here. Let me show you this, and all of a sudden, ooh, synchronize! Hit the circle button. And so now it kind of gives you this little panoramic view, but all of these, you know, this surrounding area on your radar... Wait, radar is over that way now. You'll see that the area is now a little more... what is this button? No, that's the share button. What about this? There we go, that's the button I want. So now it's kind of like fog of war, if you're familiar with that term. Where that surrounding area now, we now know everything that's in this area. We know we're in Cape Buena Vista, that's nice. We know there's another, what do they call these things? A viewpoint. Fine there. And then there's another one out east, and what the hell is that? Is that our fallen ship? Could be. Could easily be. But there's also all kinds of things. There are Animus fragments, which I don't know what purpose they have in the game, but there's a chest here with apparently a low amount of loot. There's another chest. There are chests all over the place. There are letters, message in a bottle type deal. And this is just like in the wilderness area. Now, there is this here, a jaguar. Certain areas do have just wild animals that will try to kill you on sight because they're wild animals. Now, when you get to the top of one of these viewpoints, there's usually a way to leap down. You take that leap of faith just to get back down to the ground a lot easier, whether it be like a stack of hay. This, you can see there's a pile of leaves right at the base of those two trees, right in front of Edward's head. So, now you can't just walk off the edge. You have to willingly want to do this. So you have to hold R2, the run button, and then X while moving forward to jump, and you'll do a swan dive leap into it. So, whoop! Landing safely. Now you can stay in here as means of camouflage, and that's a good little, you hit the circle button, and if there's guards walking around the area, they'll kind of be like, wait a minute, what was that noise coming from that pile of fucking leaves? And that's a good way for you to get kills on people. But
where's he working?
You know what? Do I just want to clean this area up of all of its fucking loot before I even go to kill this guy? Nah, let's just move with the game. I will have... That's one of the things I will do in the long run. Is collect a lot, if not all, of these fucking items you saw on the map here. Project Gaming. That's just how I roll. Oh shit, see, there's jaguars in the area. Oh shit, he's right there, wasn't he? Isn't that him? Let's not try to find out and just run. With killing some of the animals, though, you'll get things like their pelt, which you can use to upgrade your suits.
We could work together on this!
This guy don't want to work together, I assure you. Can I climb up this? Oh, kind of. I don't know where I want to go here. Oh, but there's another viewpoint. This is nothing to fucking worry about, so let's do this. Synchronize! So now we will have more of the area mapped out, so to speak. These are some of the first things you should go to get when you get to a new area. Because now, okay, there's more shit up here. What are these? There's more chests. That's really cool. Ooh, what is this little musical note? Those are the shanties. Learn a new shanty for your crew. A song. You know. That'll be a little bit later. The Mayan Stella. That is something way later in the game, I'll just have you know right now. So even if you wanted to collect all these things, straight up, now is just not the time to even bother for those. Take it from me. Whoop, climb down, climb down. Where did that guy go exactly? Can I leap across from here? I don't think so. I mean, I should be, like, actually giving chase, but, fuck it. You know what? Let's climb up. Come on, guy. Edward Kenway is the guy's name. Let me just leap and jump off. Fuck it. And it doesn't even always have to be extremely deep water. So long as they let you do that swan dive. Whoa-hoo, you son of a bitch. Shooting me. Sneaky shit. And sometimes, like, when you're giving chase like this, or running away from a group of people, trying to find your next area to run to and jump to and leap to can sometimes be a bit of a fun challenge. Because you just never know what is grab-onable, what you can leap onto. Ledges of buildings, running up the trunk of a tree kind of thing. Oh, I think we're gaining on them. Yeah, slash, here we go. Too late for you, son. Oh, yeah. Dead. Fuck him. Fuck him. That's too fucking bad. Yup. And now let's drag his sorry carcass elsewhere. What you got in that pouch there, son? What is that? Looks like a jar or something.
Senor Duncan Walpole, I accept your most generous offer and await your arrival with eagerness. If you truly possess the information we desire, we have the means to reward you handsomely.
Drag the body in the weeds, very smart.
Though I will not know your face by sight, I believe I can recognize the costume made infamous by your secret order.
Aha!
Therefore, come to Havana in haste, and trust that you shall be welcomed as a brother. Suma su humilde servidor, el gobernador Laureano Torres y Ayala.
Governor, big name. So, this is identity theft.
Mr. Walpole, let's collect your reward.
Mr. Walpole? Okay. Stupid fucking name. Not that Kenway is the best name, but... Well, we're doing a little bit of identity theft right now. Well... Like I said, I'm not going to clear out all this shit right now, but through this Project Gaming that I like to, you know, consider myself to be avid within, yeah, eventually I will collect all of these things here once we get back to Cape Bonavista a little bit later, but I don't know how much later. It's going to be hours, I tell you that much. But here's where we are, the little, you know, hooded face. And this red zone here, this indicates an area of trespassing. So once we're within this red zone, we will be basically attacked on sight. But also there appears to be a...
That schooner'll do me just fine.
Yeah, let's steal that ship. Warning, restricted area. And it tells you, but let's synchronize. Let's get the eagle eye, the viewpoint. Oh, what do they... I keep fucking up the name. Let's... I don't know. Scan the area. There we go. Oh, do you see the little map icon? Right above Kenway's head there, that's what that is. A little rectangle with a squiggly dotted line and a red X. Now, since we... Holy shit. We know what all this place looks like, although there's nothing else around here except... the area that we started. But you can see how much bigger the area got. So, okay. Well, we need to progress forward. Oh, what is this? This little animal is a howler monkey. Howler monkeys, I don't think, attack you. They'll run away, as a matter of fact. Certain things, jaguars and I think pumas and shit like that. Animals that you would suspect, you know, can kill you are the ones that can kill you. But there's other ones like little, I don't know, like anteater-looking things. Howler monkeys. You can kill them for the pelt or other such, you know, for crafting materials and whatnot. But always at the end of these little viewpoints, you can swan dive into something. So it's safe. It's safe. That's kind of an automatic within these games. Now, another thing. Now that I progress forward a little bit.
Where to commandeer this other ship and follow?
Sorry, Kingston? No, no, our destination is Havana. I'm just a merchant.
Quiet, you bleeding pirate! You'll hang for the mess you made out there!
Sir, I had nothing to do with this attack. My crew and I have merely anchored to water and resupply.
Now, when you're in a restricted area, well, I think any area. You can see when you get over to... there's plenty of points of camouflage, and mainly like tall weeds like this. You can see how you kind of flicker, and then... Like, I'm invisible right now. They don't know where I am. Well, they don't know that I'm here to begin with. You can see guys walking around on the shore.
Anything you like.
You can see them, I believe, on the map. Now that we're close enough? No. But you can see them on the radar at the very least. You can see red dots walking around in front of me. Those are definite bad guys that will attack you on sight.
Oh God.
See, when you're in plain view... you all of a sudden turn back colorful and bright and vibrant. When you're hiding in the weeds, you're crouched down and you're pretty much like black and white. Just a visual aid reference.
Take anything you like.
These weeds aren't tall enough to hide in. Oh, look at this. At the edge of this, we gotta make sure that no one's around when we do this. See, swan dive off, and you're in safely. Look, there's a turtle crawling along. Look at him. I think you can kill the turtles, actually. Because I think tortoise... Maybe you can use the shell for something. All right, I'm going to wait till these guys kind of clear out. And I'm going to swan dive into the leaves right in front of me. That's good enough. He turned. Now. Whoop. Stalking zones. And that's basically just telling you the weeds. Dense vegetation can be used as stalking zones. They allow you to hide and move undetected. Use them to approach guards stealthily.
Take my sugar! Take anything you like!
Now, since we're laying low in the weeds here, remember how I said you can kind of whistle and get these guys all fucking killed? Watch this.
I'll pay you! Anything you like!
He heard something. Just hitting the square button. That'll do it. That will do it.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
I thought... Oh, there is loot on him. When you kill somebody, standing over their body and hitting the holding the circle button, you will kind of loot their corpse.
Take anything you like.
And whether it's bullets for your gun... Hold on. Oh, he heard something. You can kind of see there's a white outline around him. And that little meter above his head, now he's suspicious.
I'll pay you. Anything you like.
Kill you. And... Loot his corpse for 9R. I forgot what the R is for, but it's gold, money. I think they're known as reels. I forgot. Ooh, but okay, there's a chest over here on the radar we can... Oh, there it is. It's kind of shining right in front of us.
Take anything you like.
See it? Bling! As it shimmers. Brightly and mightily. I think I can get this without being seen. Yeah. People's vision in this game is not too great. Piao, kick it open. $339. Now, there is something in front of us. One of these animus fragments. Although, I don't think it's right in front of us. I think it's higher up. Yeah. Oh, yeah. See that bright gold thing right there? That's something you're able to collect for later. Still on the radar. And just for note, I don't think these treasure chests reload themselves, as, you know, like, once you clear them out, they're gone. Uh-oh.
I'll pay you.
Wait for it, wait for him to get closer. And, here, oh, perfect. I heard something. What was that noise? Metal Gear Solid. And...
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Well, that merchant just can't shut the fuck up, can he? $14.
Take my sugar! Take anything you like!
Dough. Okay, there's three guys up there, which is kind of a problem. Or is it a problem? Got an idea.
Anything you like!
Let me work back around here. Stay in the dense vegetation. Like, literally, they're... Their line of sight is not too great in this game. Oh, no, there's only two. The guy with the blue dot over his head, he's someone we need for, you know, progression. Uh-oh, he saw something. I just stepped out.
Take
just
my
a
sugar.
Little bit.
Take anything you like.
Now, hold on, let me see if I can do this. Huh? I whistled. That guy's got a long-ass bayonet.
I'll pay you! Anything you like!
And we're still somehow stealth through all of this. He didn't see a thing. So, loot the corpse. $13.
Oh, God!
Let me attract this guy. It's kind of who you're looking at. And this guy's like 12 o'clock straight in front of me, so...
Take my sugar! Take anything you like!
Shut up, merchant. I'm trying to do really well here. And $9 there. Okay, so... What's up, buddy?
I'll pay you! Anything you like!
Oh, okay. Well, I guess I wasn't supposed to kill him. Where's... Oh, the merchant's lying on the ground. I'm sorry.
By God's grace, sir. You
I should
saved
have
me.
Stealthed that
profusion
guy.
Profusion of thanks.
Is that yours?
It is my vessel, yes. But here lies its poor captain, and I have no art for sailing.
I can pilot her myself, no mind.
You don't mean to abscond with my ship, do you?
I'm Duncan. What's your name, friend?
Steed Bonnet.
Well, Mr. Bonnet, let this stay twixt us. But I'm on a secret errand for His Majesty the King, God save him, and I must get to Havana with speed.
Ah, oh, that is a relief, sir. Havana is also my destination. Our ways lie together.
Natural allies, then.
Ah, you put me at ease, sir. To think I took you for a pirate when you first appeared.
Did you?
Yes. You have an uncommon way of handling yourself. Quick and easy, if I may say. Gave me quite a fright. But all things considered, I think it's turned out to be a rather fortuitous day, hasn't it?
This merchant's kind of... he's like an oddball character.
Lacking a rowboat, I'm afraid we'll have to swim to my ship.
Hardly the worst thing to happen.
And there's a corpse. Well, that map piece that I saw, now it leads to treasure. Treasure maps, you can find them on explorers' cadavers. They will lead you to a specific place on an island. Dig there and you might find money or plans to upgrade your ship. Your ship you don't have yet, even this one that's in front of us. I don't think that's the one that we get to use in the long run. But anyways, use left or right on the D-pad to select the maps and press triangle to open them. The coordinates will lead you to the location, and the image will help you find the right spot. This feature is also accessible from the second screen. Whatever that means.
Second screen.
So, well, that kind of looks like the area that we're at, and there's a little cove just to the south, so... looks like there's three trees, turn right around south-ish. There should be a log or something, and... yeah? Wait, press left and right, select the treasure map, and then hit triangle. Okay. Well, if I know right... if I remember right... it was just back through here, this little lagoon, whatever you want to call it, area. High-stepping through the water. And... at least I thought it was back this way. Well, that's... pressing the R3 stick in, this is kind of like your, well, I don't even know what you would fucking call it. It helps you to see things beyond where you're currently at. Stealth areas light up really bright. You can see all that green for those bushes in front of me. Those are highly stealthy areas for you to sneak to. And then enemies also appear, well, I mean, they're all dead, but they would really show up bright red as they're walking around. And then this little hiding spot here with the dead weeds that we jumped into. Dead leaves. Well, hold on a second now. It says... it should be right around back there. Well, were there coordinates on this thing at all? I don't think so. But, I mean, if that's the ship, this is clearly where we're at. Down here and, like, what, around the bend? It should be somewhere along this wall, I would presume. Unless we're not meant to find this right now, which could also be the case. Oh, nope. Oh no, there's nothing there. That's weird. Huh. Oh, no, dig. Okay. Just gotta find the right spot, and then it says dig. So this is where the treasure from that map is. Oh, big old... that's a big trunk. Take that thing with, that's good storage. Or just kick it open, you know, whatever. Fucking brute, huh? 1500 bucks. Excavator, you have earned a trophy. So that's what that says when that mosaic blurb shows up on the screen. Okay, let's get to this guy's ship. And this is just a quick fucking course through the game. I mean, once we get to Havana... ooh-wee, I Remember the first time I got there, I totally cleared out everything. One of the first things I want to do, of course, is get all the viewpoints. No worry, like, in these areas, I don't think there's any fucking... As far as, like, swimming like this through water, you can only go so far and the game will tell you, stop it. Otherwise, you'll be using a lot of ships, so there's really not a worry of, you know, sharks or things like that. Take the wheel, alright.
Welcome aboard, Duncan. She's a modest schooner, but well suited to my purpose, trafficking cargo from my plantation and such.
She'll do fine. There's a strong wind now. Let's strike to full, shall we?
Now, when, the left stick steers you left and right, the right stick rotates the camera for
there's a tug of
when
the wind
combat
in my
is needed.
Hair. I find a bracing comfort in the feel and smell of the ocean. The raw stink of possibility.
But to get going...
That's a top way of seeing it, mate.
The X button is used for acceleration, and you basically have, like, three speeds. You can see the anchor in the upper corner. Means we're pretty much as still as we can get.
Let out some sail!
One sail, two sails... Well, okay, we can't get top speed just yet. That's more for really high-speed shit. But the faster you go, the tougher it is to maneuver. So you kind of want to play to that. It's kind of like any driving game, you know. You want to take that corner better? Slow it down. Which you'd hit
We've
circle
really
to lower
now,
the sails or even drop anchor in full. Drop anchor. You know, if you gotta take a poop, you drop an anchor.
Animated by the idea of pirates roaming these waters. Is it a real danger, do you suppose?
A possibility. But most pirates stalk the windward passage between Cuba and Hispaniola.
Oh, I see. Yes. That is a bustling strait.
I mean, this all
looks... I shouldn't worry about being waylaid by pirates, truth be told. My ship is small, and I have nothing of immense value. Sugarcane and its yields, molasses, rum, that sort of thing.
There's not a pirate living who turned his back on a keg of rum.
Look, flamingos.
Well, yes. Yes, I suppose that's true.
I didn't think I was going to be able to traverse through this. This looks really fucking narrow.
Swim out to the wind.
Top speed. Well, there is one more speed faster than this, but you can't do it through tight quarters. Also, if you look on the radar, you can see that little diagonal yellow line that's aiming off the butt of our ship. That's the wind, like, kind of direction where it's coming from. So you can kind of get a feel for it. Sometimes it'll be like, yeah, see, now it's a red line. It was yellow, sometimes it'll be three lines. Now it's back to yellow, so it's calmer wind. Even though it's somewhat against us, you can kind of see where it literally points down to.
Ease off the wind!
Oh boy, make that corner. Turn, goddammit.
Loose main sails!
Maneuvering your ship.
Every last scrap of duck on the
wing. Especially when you start getting into, like, naval battles. When you start pirating and shooting, you know, other ships around, that's when the shit gets really fucking, really fun and interesting. Wow-wee. Did you see that whale? That was tremendous. That will happen a lot when you're out. You'll just see schools of dolphin jumping, you'll see a shark, you'll see a whale.
You're a natural sailor, Duncan.
I did a decent trick at the helm some time ago. 2 years before the mast as a privateer.
Dash my buttons. Your life seems a grand one, if I may say. So full of adventure. How marvelous.
I've seen my share of strangeness, aye.
So now we're going to Havana. And although the geographical shit is not incredibly accurate in this game, it's represented, I think, well enough. I mean, I live down around Miami, Florida, so...
Fantastic work. Very
okay,
promising.
This is the virtual reality shit that I was talking about at the beginning. Heroes aren't born, you've earned a trophy. This is just a loading screen out of nothing... Wait, action completed plus 10 on Uplay. Alright, does that show up on the stream? I mean, the mosaic blurb.
Easy now. There you go. Welcome back. Well, your numbers look good. Now let's make sure we can break your brain, alright?
Hmm.
I need you to move your head and look at these lights just here.
What lights? Where?
Look up.
Sure.
That's it. Down. So far, so good. Let's get you up.
This is like the modern day virtual reality type shit.
Welcome to the Sample 17 project. Before you get started, you're gonna need this. There you go. Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. Hello, bonjour. C'est bon? It works?
Yes, it works.
All right, let's take a walk. Your file says you've done some memory research before, but not to this extent, which is surprising. You're very good. The data streams are very stable.
Essentially, what they're looking to do, if I can explain this quickly, it seems as if they're trying to make a reality show or they're trying to make a movie out of these memories. I don't know how this all works, whatever, but this is the stupid part of the game, I think. Like I said, the pirating, that's the shit that I want to do.
Impressive, right? This building is barely 6 months old, but Abstergo Entertainment has been a studio for a few years, since 2010.
I really like the way the line runs up the back of the stockings. I always like those kind of high heels, too. Van Halen reference.
Maybe you saw Liberation? That was our first title powered by Animus Tech. That was just the tip of the iceberg. Soon, we'll be unveiling commercial Animus servers for the whole world to enjoy. They'll offer passive experiences, of course. Edited versions of real history. But only the exciting parts. And we think we found the perfect subject for our first full-length virtual feature. Caribbean Pirate.
So it's like we're making a video game in a video game.
It'll just take a minute, okay?
You know, Oculus Rift type shit.
Well, thank you, Nancy. Bonjour.
Excuse me. What,
C'est bon, c'était prêt.
Magnifique. Merci.
Oh god, they're French.
This is for you. The primary tool of our trade.
A
your
tablet.
Communicator.
A tablet.
Power it up and give it a look. It's pretty slick.
Ooh, how do I power it up? X. My file's
you
square.
Might have
Oh, that shut her up. Employee passport. I don't know what any of this shit, I don't care. Blah, blah, blah. Abstergo. You'll see that name throughout the game. I don't know if there's a link between... I don't know. DNA memories, blah, blah, blah. Building plan. I guess that was, like, everything important, but, whatever.
That security like I said. Seems a little light around here. That's because your communicator is your key to getting around.
I don't care. Can I put this thing away? So where are we going? Go pirate more shit, huh?
See that flashing wireless signal?
Yeah.
It means you're hooked up to the elevator. I'll let you do the honors. We're headed up to the Sample 17 studio, second floor.
Wait, no, not my files. Fuck, wrong thing. What, do I have to be, like, touching it? Oh, circle. I'm sorry. Floor 2. This is so stupid. So we're basically in the real life portion of this game.
Let's go.
We're like building Oculus Rift virtual reality bullshits so people can experience historical events of the past.
There's the boss, Olivier Garneau, our CCO. I'll introduce
as opposed to historical events of the future.
Salut, Mélanie. Ça va bien?
Well, thanks. Have you met our new hire? Just started today.
I haven't. Bonjour. What project?
Sample 17, the Kenway line.
Kenway.
Adam, Connor.
Edward, the pirate.
Ah, arr, matey.
Very exciting. Welcome aboard. Mélanie, can we talk in your office for a minute?
Just let me get this one settled and I'll see you in 5 minutes.
C'est bon. Nice to meet you.
Sure thing. Like
so, this is the Sample 17 floor. We're diving into the memories of one very generous donor, Desmond Miles. We're pulling all the best stuff from his DNA. And hopefully, one day, we can forge some fantastic experiences from what we find in there.
Okay.
This pair of legs is John, one of the wizards in IT. He's just fixing something for you.
Not fixing, calibrating.
Same thing.
Calibrating, right. So here we are. Your very own Animus workstation.
Ooh.
This is all yours, so sit back, relax, and find us some good footage.
Oh, I will.
If you need any hints or tips, the Animus is loaded with tutorial programs, so you'll have no problems. And I'll check
in
on you later.
Wow, my own circular office place in the middle of everything. Now, what was this little figurine over here? Can I interact with that in any such way? I don't know. Well, oh. There we go. Circle. Animus.
Welcome to Animus Omega, Abstergo Entertainment's proprietary ancestral memory research tool. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns about how to operate your Animus console, please contact your project supervisor, Melanie LeMay. You have been registered as part of the Sample 17 project. Your primary research target is Edward James Kenway, born March 10, 1693, Swansea, Wales. Calibrations complete.
He's bloody
Welsh.
All signs
normal. All systems optimal. Extra neurotransmitters activated.
Who's sending me messages? That's what that mosaic blurb was. Woohoo! Havana! Cuba! It's much worse nowadays. But now that we're back to the meat and potatoes of the game. Hey, here we go! That was like the intro, essentially, so. That would make a great thumbnail on my fucking YouTube channel. Or so would that ship.
Lively Havana. I've been here once before. It was a truly awful pleasure.
I see someone you know.
No. Just putting on a friendly face. I shouldn't want to be mistaken for a pirate again.
Right. Flash rogue like yourself must be cautious.
Pirates beware. Oh, bullshit.
Mad to think Spain and England were at war 2 years ago, isn't it? Here I am, bartering with Spaniards like they were my cousins. Nothing wrong, Duncan?
No, it's nothing. Sand in my hampers. So where's the best squad in town? I'm dying for a quick kip. Or a siesta, should I say.
I'm just headed to, a public house now to meet some merchants. I could show you the way.
Well, lead on.
Carry the heavy shit.
I hope you'll tarry a bit while I conduct my meeting. It'd be a great relief to have a man of your stature nearby in case of a misunderstanding.
I can hang about. I might have a drink.
Spend it. Drink.
Now,
they
you
don't
will
take
notice
kindly to pirates here, do they? Wonder how many stolen reals bought these men this perch.
You will notice the red guys on the radar right now. God damn it, friend request. Good for you. Mosaic blurbs on my stream. Anyway, you'll notice the red.
Hola, ladies.
Oh, yeah.
You don't know these women, do you?
No. They charge money for that kind of privilege. A few dozen reals for every hour of knowing.
And yes. Now, the ladies, the dancers, if you will, you can use them as tactical decoys for a price. So the ladies do come in handy.
Oh, goodness no, I'm a married
Giggity.
Man.
Married men are their forte, mate.
But you can see, the guys that are red characters on the, hold on, can I? Yeah, okay, here's what I was talking about. See how he's lit up red? Oh, this is also how you mark individuals. But granted, I'm not in a, restricted zone. So even though he's, like, seen as an enemy, he's not going to attack me on sight because I have not committed a crime. I'm not in a restricted zone. So, and you can see, after you press in the left stick and get these guys highlighted, a little dot comes above their head. Once you exit this, that's Eagle Eye mode, I think, is what they call it. They will stay kind of lit up really red, even when you get back into normal viewing mode here. So you can kind of see, even like when they go beyond walls. really good for tracking down enemies when you're in a stealth area, so you can track all their movements.
I should acquire a blade for myself, Duncan, just as you have.
This rusty razor's nothing to admire.
Even so, I appear a mere kitten walking so close.
More ladies up ahead. Any sort of companions show up in blue?
Maybe I'll buy a sword too.
We'll both jump rank.
Oh, we'll be quite the pair, you and I.
Ladies.
Twin devils.
See, there's a restricted zone up ahead.
Lend us a few reals, then. I did save your skin.
Ah, of course.
Cheers.
Woohoo! All right. Now what are we doing?
Bienvenido, señor.
Hola, señor. Sword sets, pistol sets, ammunitions, outfits, pieces of art, sell some cargo, sell hunting goods. Buy hunting goods. Well... Oh, I can't even check these lists. Alright, I gotta go sword sets. British cutlasses. I think that's the only ones I can get. There's a lot. Look at that. 14,000 reals. For that set of swords. And yeah, they have, I guess stats to them. Speed, combo, and damage. Depending on what you like. There is no wrong sword so long as you have one. Now, what, should I buy these? Well, they're only telling me I can buy the British cutlasses. So, I will confirm that. That's kind of what my mission is right now.
That's a better fit for me. How do you fare?
I had only enough for a small knife, sadly. Still, it'll do in a pinch. Oh, Puffer Duff. I have led us astray, Duncan.
Oh, no matter. I'll get us a better view. What are we looking for?
A tavern with a sort of courtyard interior.
Gotcha. Reach the top of the church. Well, that's this building here. No, you have to beware in cities when you're climbing around rooftops. You shouldn't do that because any of the enemies will go after you because you're, in that point you're kind of up to no good. And you can see this area in front of me is a red blocked out trespassing area. If you get in there, well, then the guards are going to do their thing. Oh, and also you can pick people's pockets. If you get behind them and hold circle with nobody noticing, actually people can, you just can't pick their pocket face to face. That's the only thing. Well, there's a hay bale, so we know that we can jump into that from a high up range. Let me just pick a pocket here. Hold down the circle button and, oh, missed out. Come on, get closer. So much easier with people that are standing. 13 reels. Now, okay, see how this just went all ghostly and ethereal? We can't move past this point in the game. Just, they won't let us. So, okay, and that'll happen when you're out on your boat. Your ship. So take mind of that. Now, how in the hell do we run up this building? Well, probably climb the tree, perhaps. Maybe climb this door frame? Ooh, yeah, climb the door frame. Scoot our way up, and look, just look at the athleticism.
My goodness, you're an agile chap.
Every finger's a fishhook. That's how you tell a true sailor.
Yes, a fine way to put it.
I mean, I really couldn't hear. That's why I put subtitles on. I couldn't hear what he said, though, but he's just amazed at my athleticism. So, no, get here and then drop. Nope, not drop down there. Crawl across this. Pull yourself up and synchronize. So now we're kind of getting the zoned out area. Look at the beautiful scenery here.
Well, they I really see the place. We're not far.
Uh-oh.
Hang tight.
Oh, shit. Gotta help somebody. Swan dive. Come here, you son of a bitch, what'd you do?
When I catch you.
I'm gonna kill you. Come here. I don't even have a gun. Oh yeah, gore.
You robbed the wrong man, mate. Fellow
yes, you
with dangerous
did.
Friends.
And see, like, even the citizens, they don't do anything. When they fucking... They just witness me kill people. I think you can just kill people in normal. Like I said, even picking pockets. Just get behind her. Hold the button. Oh, she's arguing with somebody. So even these two, they're arguing with each other. Everybody else that I'm passing by, they don't notice that I'm picking pockets. I pick his pocket too. Fuck him. Another $2. It's not much, but early in the game, it is kind of nice to build up a little bit of coin this way. Steed, what? Yeah, Steed Bonnet. What a fucking weird name.
Duncan! By Jove, you're alive!
Of course I am. That filch was no fuss.
Oh, yeah.
Haha! Ah, look at this. Arrived. Rum for all. Guy's carrying two fucking kegs. That's my kind of place.
Take your time, I'll be just here.
Fancy meeting a Welshman deep in Dago country. I'm English myself. Biding my time till the next war calls me to service.
Lucky King George having a piss pot like you flying his flag.
Lucky, huh?
Oi! Skulk! I've seen your face before. Yous mates with them pirates down in Nassau.
Shut your fucking gob or I'll fill it with shot, you hear me?
Edward, is it?
Give him the old Glasgow kiss.
Hey, I warned him.
Okay, now it's on. Now it's on. Fuck the cutscene, here we go.
You wanna
y'all gonna get yours.
I'll give you one. Come on, lads. I've seen bigger arms on a bird.
Oh, so they want me to... So this is like just a combat tutorial. Circle, circle. Okay. Circle to counter, then X to attack. Haha! Circle to counter, then square to knock out. Come on. Pow, bitches! Circle, square. Holy shit. Normally I'm just kind of button masher about this. Circle the counter. Kick him in the nuts. Curb stomp him. Oh. Punched him in the ball sack. Oh boy.
You're not leaving me. I'll catch you up.
Perro Ingles.
Oh shit. Hold on. Smoke bomb! Use left and right on the D-pad to select the smoke bomb and then press triangle to use it. Smoke bombs incapacitate enemies for a few seconds, allowing you to escape or kill them easily. There they are. Smoke bomb! Now see all these guys with the yellow and the red things above their head? Oh, I only have a fucking... fists. Oh, oh, this is useful. That thing's useful, let me use it. I knew about that. It looks like a little workbench up against some buildings. Take to the rooftops just like Predator, right? And just run. Run like the Dickens. Okay, they're all looking for me yet. Ah, shit, somebody spotted me. Fuck, fuck, all because I'm on the rooftops. These little, you can hide in here. But they saw me, so it's not going to do any good. There are spots like that all over. Yeah, let me just... I just got to run away here really quick. And these guys are also as athletic as you, maybe not as quick. Oh! Perfect. There's something up there. See that thing floating above the clothesline? Oh, that's the shanty. That's the pirate's song sheet. Just wait for the heat to cool down. They don't know I'm here. There's two guards right there. They have no clue. Unless they start stabbing their swords in the hay bale. Escape the area and hide. Well, I'm hiding. This ain't good enough. Oh, okay. The heat's cooling down, I think. Hide inside haystacks and similar objects to become invisible. Sweet, sweet, sweet. Way to go, Ruru. That's R-O-O-R-O-O 93123. G checking in along the live streamage. Maybe I shouldn't be in this area. Maybe I have to. Maybe I need to exit this entire red circle. So if that's the case, let me, I wanna make a fucking dash for it. Oh, that guy's up on the roof. Okay. We're on this way. We just keep going north. No, I need to make a turn. This guy's up ahead. Okay, so let me escape the zone. Oh, okay. Tackle the pickpocket. I didn't tackle him, I killed him. And I use smoke bombs. Ooh! Oh, damn it, see, I can't quite see. Rate this memory. Well, view the details. Options. Sequence 2. Okay, so 15% complete. How so? I want to rate this memory, but I don't know exactly how, because my face bubble's in the way. Rate this memory. I like it. On a star level. That's good. So you hit square, the stars come up, adjust it up or down, and then complete. Okay, so I'm done with that. Continue. Blip. Good! Okay, now that's all the shit to do in Havana. Viewpoints, contracts, all that stuff. Now our next mission is back this-a-way, towards the docks. And my sugar, you can see Havana's, actually, like, if I zoom out, like, this is, like, the world map. And it's fucking huge. Like, this is technically Florida all through here. This would be the Florida Keys, essentially. This is, I think one of these is Nassau. I forgot which one exactly. But this would be, like, the Caribbean Islands. This big chunk that we're on, this is Cuba. And I thought, was that Jamaica down here? No, or maybe this, no. Kingston, I thought, was down here. It was right by one of these. See these black lines? These are the dividing lines of, like, difficulty. Punta Gorico is medium. Navassa is medium difficulty. Charlotte is hard difficulty. Just within these black lines is where the difficulty is separated. But I think right in this cove right here is where Kingston is. Way down in Jamaica. But I mean, if we are here in Havana, in the Dry Tortuga region, which, where's the black line here? Goes all the way here. Yeah, Dry Tortuga is like the biggest region in the world map. But as we zoom in, like, this is all of Havana. Walkable ground. And you can see, we don't have much zoned out in this area. But, I guess for argument's sake right now, let's get to the main quest area. Which is... And my sugar! So we know we're dealing with our fat, chubby, our merchant friend. Which, okay, we don't have any heat on us. Okay, we can just run through people, that doesn't matter. I don't suggest you do that against, like, the guards of the city. They might take offense to it. Let's run up here just for fun. Whoop, 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 whoop. Oh, we should get down so we don't attract attention. People are yelling at us in Spanish. Same thing down here in Miami. So many Cubans and Puerto Ricans and Haitians and... Oh. Now, you can utilize the ladies to help you in certain matters. You can hire them for 150 reals. Ooh, that's a lot of money for my cheap ass. But let's talk to our guy. Start mission.
Sorry about the swift exit. Bit of a misunderstanding.
One heaped upon another.
Oh, Jesus. Oof. I'm sorry, mate. This is my doing. I'm only trying to keep these Spanish eyes off me.
Oh, it's no bother. Regrettably, the soldiers confiscated my sugar. But when your dispatches...
Damn! And where have they gone?
Haven't the foggiest idea, I'm afraid. I suspect those chaps might, but my Spanish is wee mal dad, so I'd rather not ask.
Shit! All right, come on, let's follow them and recover my maps.
And my sugar?
What, in my drawers? We'll see what happens.
I need my maps. What about my sugar? Okay, now, yeah, use Eagle Eye. There, it tells you, use L3. All right, well, I have them locked in. I already kind of showed you that, but these are, like, quest-specific individuals, so they show up as yellow, if I know right. You can tag up to 10 enemies, tagging them, you know, when they're highlight red or yellow and the little dot appears above their head. Those are the important ones. Also, we want to tail them, but not make it so obvious that we're tailing them. So hide behind cover like this.
I believe I'm getting the hang of this.
No, you are not. But see, like, even though they're beyond the building.
Hang back.
No. I wanted to hide. We'll get on this side of the building. And the meter disappears. Join a group of people in a crowd to become invisible. Which does help. You'll see your character will kind of flicker. So if I stand here amongst these people,
shoot.
See how that happened? Now we're a little more camouflaged because we're in the group of people here.
Yes, sir.
Oh, you know what?
We're very sorry. Our captain delayed us.
Take some money while we're just standing amongst these people. $14, that's good. Okay, they're going in here. Oh, it's a restricted area.
Captain Mendoza? Yes, sir. He's very excited to meet you, only he must be present for a hanging, señor.
Hanging?
Huh.
Oh, I love a good hanging.
Yes, sir. Very nice.
Okay, they just walked through a restricted area. Hello, ladies. Picking pockets, don't mind me. Where I want to get the other guy tagged. There we go.
Man owes me money for the slave authority.
Of course, sir.
Captain Mendoza has.
It looks like they're entering another restricted area.
Sugars and such.
Excellent.
So this must be where the shit's being held, I'm assuming. Don't wait. My face bubble thingy was in the way yet again, so I couldn't quite see. I do enjoy this game way too much, which is why I'll probably be clearing things out in full. Uh-oh.
Let's not dilly-dally.
Yes, sir. We go.
Now they're picking up the pace a little bit, and I'm wondering why. Of course, we are like athletic as balls, so... Head down the alleyway, alright. See if they... Whoop. They go back into a restricted area. I might be screwed. Don't worry about me. Alright, run, go do your thing. Almost there, they say. Walk far enough away. He won't suspect a thing. Trying to give a little bit of chase here. Eavesdrop on the conversation. Not enough, huh? All right, let me get in the group of girls. They make good decoy. Eavesdrop interrupted. Gotta stay in range of... Oh, fuck it. Hire him for $150. Let's... Come on, ladies.
Quick as anything, sir. Captain Mendoza needs only to hang the man, then he will deliver your payment.
I don't want the alleys, man. I want goods. Things I can sell. Tobacco, rum, sugar.
We have money! much fine sugar. Great, we took off a fat Englishman last night.
Englishman?
We're approaching the hangman.
Sugar from Barbados. Very fine. We hold it in the Castillo after the man started the fight last night. He ran, left his sugar behind. Very fine.
Well, that's a start. Shall I accompany him to the Castillo?
She's like clipping through his hand.
Captain Mendoza will have it sent to you, I believe.
He's clipping through her hand.
You will see.
Okay, I'm eavesdropping plenty.
Is that big brute your Captain Mendoza?
No, sir.
Let me pick some pockets while I'm here.
El Tiburon, Governor Torres's man.
Oh shit, what am I going for? That guy? Hail this captain. Okay. Stand in with the ladies. Oh, I have another. I got another set of hose. Well. Uh-oh. Oh boy. Steal the captain's key. All right, he's got a key on him. Good to know, but he's in a restricted area. So, what I want to do, I need to distract the guards with the ladies I got. So, ladies, show them a good time.
Give them something. Distract.
Oh, and they're all over him. Okay. Kill him. Take the key. Now where did these guards go? Did they run off with the girls? Because I shouldn't be here. Although it happens later, let me try to do something right now. You might be able to take out two guys at once. I don't know that for fact. Swords, maybe I'm able to. Let me, nope. Restricted area, but you know what the good thing is? There's a chest right here. May as well take this, for what we got. 198 bucks and one of 20 chests in Havana. One of 20. You saw it right. Sneak up to the fort lockup. Holy shit. Alright, so this big area, a big old restricted area. I need to somehow get in, find where everything is. Oh boy. Oh, okay, there's a guard over here, but we're not in restricted space yet. Hey, buddy. Let's do it this way. Yeah, stab him. Okay, well, I can't loot his corpse from inside a hay bale. That's the only downside. Otherwise, well, we need to get inside this, this area. So, whoa. Oh shit. Okay, well, we're in restricted area, remember, so this is just going to be tough to deal with, all things considered. See, but you can't quite pin the guy. Unless he's damn near dead center of your viewing.
Alto!
Connection error, how? Oh shit, what's up, guy? How you doing? I didn't notice there were two of you. 11 bucks there. 11 bucks, I say. 13 reels there. Here's a chest, which is sometimes tough to get to, if I remember right. So that's good. And a manuscript. Alright. But, remember, again, we are in, okay, apparently it's not a walk-outable door. We're in restricted area, so that's, gonna be tough for us to maneuver around, unless... Jump! Okay, good. Ooh, these, okay. Remember yesterday when I started up Uncharted? It's very much the same, except, Edward here will absolutely do this on his own, jumping height to height. You don't have to press a button, you just aim the sticks, and he does it on his own. Now, I really don't care about killing and looting everybody. Things will happen naturally, but I'm hanging off of a ledge. Oh, shit. How his buddy didn't see that, I don't know. You must die. Okay. Threw one guy off. Killed two straight up. $15. Abstergo challenge completed. Loot 10 bodies. Those are just kind of like in-game achievements, not so much PlayStation achievements. Okay, one tag. Whoop. Two tagged. Come on. And three. Okay. Shit. Smoke bomb! Easy kill. Yeah. Oh shit! Come on, son. You got your big old musket rifle with your bayonet. I say, fuck you. Oh wait, I killed everybody and that's all I need? Okay. I didn't even need to find where I had to go. Yeah, what is with that? That looked like a little jar piece again. What was that? It was a little glass something, a vial? Warning, restricted. Oh, where'd the bodies go? Oh, shit. Wow. Okay, four guys over there. Oh, where'd all the bodies go? Now it says to meet Steed Bonnet. While I'm in this area, maybe I should try to get these things here. There's a watch point, a viewpoint, still a chest, and a fragment. While I'm here, I may as well try to get these things, right? Not too keen to grab onto the... Oh, well, look at that. There it is right below me. What if I... Okay, there we go. Hitting circle will drop you down a level. Aha! Fragment. So that's good. Now, there's a chest somewhere over this away. Be right below me or something. Below me. I don't get it. Surely you do, Trebek. I can hear it twinkling. So there's gotta be like a... There's gotta be a room beneath me. Or a window to get in. Such grace and athleticism. See, look, this fucking guy can like climb around anything. All day long. I mean, I do some workouts, and I think I'm in fairly decent shape after ravaging my body for quite a while. Eating like crap and plenty of drinks. But, yeah, I get worn out after a 30-minute workout. Oh, can I take any of this stuff? No. I'm guessing... If I fuck, can I land on that? Good. I indeed can, but... can I jump over to that? I can hang on and jump in, and there we go. Found the damn chest. This one was tough to get to. But see, that's the kind of exploration you'll have to do to find all these things. And that's chest 2 out of 20. Jesus. Whoop. There we go. Holding the run button will, of course, give you a better advantage to, run and jump, essentially. Because this, I'm just holding the stick. I'm not using the R2 button to run. Drop down there. I don't know where this last spot is. Oh, let me try this. Well, this is where I came from. But it's up there, I'm pretty damn sure. Can I jump back just by chance? Of course I can. I'm athletic as balls. No, this is the room that I started in. Okay. So I need to get, like, right above where I'm at now. What a leap. Can I run up there? No, not quite yet. I'll get there. I got an idea. Jump across a little bit. Jump! Come on. Okay, then I'll climb up this way. There's a guy up there. There's guys over there. Need to get to this corner. Hopefully without being seen. I'm running around like a fucking idiot. Oh, get up there. Yep, see? Good old bell tower. And there's the bird, which he's always on the perch. And synchronize! So everything in this little restricted area we got taken care of. Plus... we have the viewpoint to see all the majesty that it lies within. What's that big-ass building here? Leap of faith! That big building. That's a big'un. And remember that hay bale where we killed that first guy that was walking around down there? Yep. That's where we get to dive into. But as you can see... wait, what am I supposed to do now? Oh, that's my destination. I just came here for fun. And he will automatically aim towards the leap of faith destination. You don't have to be so precise with it. Now this pirate shanty... it's right above me right now, which... I mean, I would have to climb the building to get it. And the shanty, because it's like literally a page of paper floating around... you have to chase it down, because it floats through the breeze in a set pattern, but still, it can be kind of a pain in the dick. Not gonna lie. And remember, when you're running on rooftops, okay, there's the shanty right above my head. But there's a guard up here. We mark him in full so we know exactly where he is. Well, I wish I had some way of killing him right now. I mean, I kind of do. Choke him out, snap his neck. Take his money. Fuck your wallet. Fuck your wallet. Oh, did the shanty move? No, I think it did. But it's right to, oh boy. Well, let's just go after it. Ah, we got it. Really quick, too. Normally it takes a little bit of time to get those things. That was a very quick pickup on my part. Also, if you're running towards a ledge or something like I just was there, and you're holding the circle button, you will drop down instead of leaping off. So, sometimes it's a little quicker. Just depending on, you know, what you want to do. Going about the motions. But since we got that done, we got our treasure back. Sorry, mate, I couldn't get your sugar. Oops, get off the wall. What am I doing? See, I love it. There, all these people. Oh, shit. No, no, no. I don't want to do that. Sorry, buddy. I made you drop your fucking, your fishing pole. I was just going to pick your pocket. No big deal. Whoop. There we go.
Sorry about the sugar. I've only one pair of hands.
Oh, it's no great loss. I've got plenty of cargo here to make a profit on my trip.
Will you stay here long?
For a few weeks, yes. Then back to Barbados, to the tedium of domesticity.
Don't settle for tedium. Sail for Nassau. Live life as you see fit.
Haven't I heard that Nassau is crawling with pirates? Seems a very tawdry place.
Not tawdry, liberated.
Oh, God. That would be an adventure. But no. No, I'm a husband and a father. I have responsibilities. Life can't be all pleasure and distraction, Duncan.
Hey, our bonnet. The name's Edward, in truth. Duncan's only a handle.
Ah. Secret name for your secret meeting with the governor.
The governor, right. I think I've kept him waiting long enough.
Remember, we are in disguise. We stole this fucking note. Oh, hire dancers to distract guards. Stay out of combat. I did not do that. Give us feedback. Rate this memory. This one, too, was... I like that. Trying to get our shit back, climbing into the fort. Not bad. Memory sync. Stay out of combat. Now, I don't know if I can go back to do this mission again to try to get 100%. Catch and loot the courier. Where's the courier? I mean, he shows up as a little treasure chest box. You see him there? There we go. Chase him down. Chase his ass down. Gotcha. Dead. Now, you can tackle him, or you can kill him like I did. And what these couriers do, they reload, they restock all of your inventory. If you got your muskets ready, all of the ammo. If you have further weapons in the game, everything involved with them there. Oh boy, they probably don't like the fact that I'm standing over a dead body, huh? Look out. Look out. Oh shit, I didn't want to do this, but okay, now we're... Oh wait, blue dots on the radar are hiding spots. When you're in, when there's heat on you and they're giving chase, blue dots will appear on the radar. Those are places you can hide. Good thing I found this one. I showed you one of these earlier, but now it's actually in use, so, you know. Yeah, see, I was running at the guy and I hit circle, which is kind of like your death tackle. You pull out your swords and you fucking gut them through. I guess running at them and hitting circle will just straight tackle them. So, there's that. I'm learning. I always just did the fucking death tackle, though. Whoop. Drop down. Now I need to meet the governor. So, let's see about that meeting. Although... Wait, where's the governor? Governor's way down there. Wow, and there's like three, four viewpoints to get. Jesus Christ. See, that's normally one of the first things that I get when I go to an area. Is to get the viewpoints. Whoa, I didn't want to zoom out. I wanted to... Set markers X. Okay, let me go get this viewpoint really quick. Before I meet up with the governor. A lot of this game, I'm telling you right now, well, a lot of this recording, is going to be me... clearing out every fucking area. All the chests, all the fragments, all of the viewpoints. What is this interaction over here? What's going on here? Free the pirates! Die, motherfucker! Leave my pirate friends alone. Get off them. The combat is somewhat similar to, like, I would say Batman Arkham stuff. Got a line on him. What do you guys, huh? Get off it. Break his defenses and run him through, motherfucker.
Thanks.
Damn
Kenway,
right,
isn't it?
How do
I'm
you know
with
who
you.
I am? Oh well. Since you guys aren't gonna loot these here bodies, I will. Yeah, that was just a little thing on the radar there. It looked like a picture. A little icon of a bunch of heads standing around. An interactive little thing that happens.
So I'm gonna, who's
See, now, I must tip my hand a little bit. I think you need to do enough of these to kind of build your reputation as being a good guy for pirate. Well, you're being a pirate. You're helping out pirates. And they might kind of co-sign for you later on, you know what I mean? It's like, oh yeah, this guy helped me out in a jam. Like, he's a good shit. He can handle himself in battle. Okay, killed a bunch of guys, got a bunch of loot out of that, which is good. There's a treasure chest nearby, I want to find that, but it might be street level this-a-way. Whoop. That's another problem. When you're running around, you tend to just run and jump up things way too often. Okay, this chest is where? Is it above me? I don't know. Or is it down below in here? Oh, bet you it's just up this way. Haha, okay. I don't know if opening these chests in front of guards will have them fucking go, batshit crazy and, want to kill you. So just be cautious of that in the meantime. Oh boy. See a bunch of red right in front of me. Oh no, they gotta be down on the street. Okay, whoops. This guy, however. Hey. Back body drop. Whoop. Stomp him. He ain't dead yet. There you go. Now he's dead. He was writhing in pain. He was going to die, but... $15 and a dead body floating. Okay, now, to get up there... Look at all the guards right there. Oh, they're just flying V formation. God damn it. Oh, shit. Drop down before you get seen. Climbing up rooftops is bad juju. It's not so much like Grand Theft Auto where there's a wanted level type scenario. Just hop down, what the hell? It's just, if you do something, they'll be, they'll be giving chase. Let me try jumping up this way. Climb up here, top of the door frame this way. There's a fragment nearby. Oh, over that circular window. Let's go do that. Can I? Yes, I can. Another fragment. 2 out of 15 found within Havana. And Havana is one of the bigger cities. But just every little area you go to. Remember the first area where I was chasing that guy down and then I stole his clothes? Yeah, little areas like that too. These little... Okay, so these are just monks, I hope. Good work, boys. Good work. Keep hammering away. So all you gotta do is just stand behind them. You can't pick their pocket face to face. And you shouldn't do it when there's a guard walking nearby. Look at this, on top of the damn cross. Yeah, I said damn cross, whatever. Oh, no. Hold up. Hold up, game. How can I effectively jump up this thing? Oh, okay, from the side. Alright, fragment. Oop, hop down. There should be a chest nearby as well. There, you know what? Let's get the waypoint taken care of. The viewpoint. Running jump over. Hoop! There we go. And we'll just work our way up from here. Straight up there, I see a couple little cracks and nooks and... Just amazing, the athleticism. Oh no, I don't even need to be that high up. Down a little bit, roll around, rotate, circle to drop, get out on the ledge, and synchronize. This is what a lot of this game is going to be. I enjoy it so much. Like I said, I don't know if I will 100% this game, but yeah, getting real stupid like that. Wow, I got $3,500 on me. That's a lot of money. Ah. There's a chest nearby. Oh! Well, I think I found it. Yep, okay. Pick that bitch open, get 130 bucks, and a gold cross, which is worth another 150. Okay, so... well, that hay bale's too far away for me to jump in. Plus, there's guards right there. I should kind of stay out of their line of sight for now. Well, you know, what the fuck, let's just utilize jumping up to jump down. Because we saw that little, that hay wagon, right? This thing's all covered in bird shit, full of white. Now, funny thing is, even doing this, the guards know nothing. No big deal. Now, what? There's something... Ooh, I'm hiding. Look, these two are having a conversation. I can... oh, shit. Nope, that guard saw me picking the pocket. Oh, boy. Yep, there's people everywhere now. Fuck me. Run through some people. Run and jump up stuff, because they will tackle you. And the rooftop guards have got rifles. Okay, let's just run and hide up this way, kind of. Oh, dear. But while you're climbing, of course, they can shoot you, so, you know, try to make haste out of your retreat. Oh, but then you can hide in here, because it's a blue dot. Haha! These guys don't give a fuck. They don't know what's going on. What if I whistle to them? Nothing? So only the guards are dumb enough. And I'm wondering, sometimes you will, the guards will be running around, like, climbing up buildings trying to chase after you. I've been the least bit fortunate so far. Yeah, but see, I was picking a pocket in front of a guard. That's how they... I don't need to be hiding in here anymore. I'll lose the heat soon enough. There we go. I need to get to my destination. Oh dear. There should be something in the bell tower here, you would think. Alright, bunch of guards. Oh shit, a bunch of guards right below me. So I shouldn't be seen up here. Because remember, like I said, hiding up in the rooftops is illegal. Can I make that rooftop? Oh, leap of faith. Barely, huh? Well, not the leap of faith. The leap of faith is specifically for jumping off something high to, oh, there's more pirate activity. Let's go help the boys. Off the rooftop for a double kill. Slice. Kill that motherfucker. Bam! Oh, ooh. We good? We good.
Thanks. Kenway, isn't it?
Damn right.
I'm with you.
There we go. Yeah, I know. Progress. Get through the game. This was the same area. Oh, well. Fuck it. Oh, looks like we lost a pirate. Well... can't be crying over spilled milk. It's worth $8 to me. I didn't know who he was. Well now. Let's move along, shall we? Let's get to the fucking destination finally. I mean, I know I said, oh, we got some viewpoints to clean up. And we do. There's that damn shanty up there on the clothesline. Here's a ladder. Let's try to get to this one quickly. See, but that's the problem with this damn game. I want to do so much stuff. It's like... I don't know, ADD distraction.
Alto!
Get out of my way. Oh, Oh, got it. 2 of 7 shanties learned in Havana. Now, not every place has this many. Hey, guys. See, I'm not in the area where all the fucking bad shit was taking place. You know what? I gotta get all the high points. I just got to, because I'm an idiot like that. Holy shit, there's one way out over the water. See what I mean? This place is huge. Like, I think, where's the ship that we started on? Like, over here? Yeah. Yeah. Fucking, there's a viewpoint right there. And there's a viewpoint, well, that's not on the water, it's just the fog of war. This out here is definitely water. This is just the fog of war. It looked like it was water to my eyes. Oh, here's a tavern where we can recruit some people, we can get some intel, we can even play games, like checkers or something similar to it. What is this? An assassin contract. I'll wait on those later. Mr. Walpole, I presume? Let's just go and do that. Let's... I guess I'm farting around enough, and I got about a half hour worth of time here before I gotta get my ass ready for work. So let's get some missions done. But you can see just how big this game can be. Now, this looks like a restricted area. How can I approach this place? And will they, start mission? Okay, apparently I can walk in it if the mission allows.
Buenos dias. Mr. Duncan Walpole of England to see the governor. I believe he is expecting me.
Okay.
Si, señor Walpole. Entre, por favor.
Entre, por favor. Thank you. Where is the governor?
Ese es el hombre. El... ¿Cómo lo llamabas? ¿Asesino?
Sí, Duncan Walpole. Debería haber llegado hace muchos días.
No me gusta que los extranjeros se paseen por nuestra ciudad. No me fío de ellos.
Cállate. El gobernador tiene invitados. Todos franceses e ingleses.
Parece un hombre rudo. Le suponía un aspecto más respetable.
Llévame ese.
They're all talking shit about me.
Gente con él.
You know, oh, I can't even run through here. I suppose, meeting the governor, I gotta be all prim and proper. Man, y'all got, like... fucking yard workers and shit like that? Come on. That was a gunshot, wasn't it? This ain't no 4th of July. It ain't even 1776.
Good morning, sir. Would I be correct in thinking you are Duncan?
I am indeed.
I thought as much.
Woods Rogers.
A pleasure. The same. I must say, my wife has a terrible eye for description. I'm sorry.
My wife. You met her some years ago at the Percy's Masquerade Ball.
Ah, quite.
She called you devilishly handsome.
Obviously a lie to stoke my jealousy.
Julianne, our guest of honor has arrived, Mr. Duncan Walpole.
Ah. Julien Ducasse. I hope your conversion to our order is an honest one. I have no love for assassins, but even less for liars.
I have not come to disappoint.
Up for a bit of sport, Duncan?
The old man isn't ready just yet.
Sure, let's shoot shit now. They give us guns and we,
You've got my two best pairs of matched pistols, Duncan, so handle them with care.
If I had 8, I'd treat each as my own son.
Pull off a few shots if you like. Get a feel for it.
I once fought beside a man who carried 9 on his person. They were a boom in battle, but hindered his ability to swim, sadly.
You see, your highlights, or your targets, sorry, light up in red.
Good kick, yes?
I long for the day where one firearm carries 4 bullets, and not the opposite.
I have a friend in England you may like to meet, Julian. James Puckett. He's working on something extraordinary.
Magnifique.
Oh, and that's another thing. You don't need to go crosshairs and shoot. You see, I'm looking at this dummy in front of me, and he's got like a white outline in front of him. now it's in front of... Well, guys, let me cross in front of you here real quick. I know that's against shooting range, but... See, now this one is highlight with the white around it. Now this one. Now this one. Now this one. You see how that works? That's kind of like a quick targeting system, so I can just hit the triangle button. Boom, there it goes. So... That's a quick sense of, getting shit done. Talk to the hosts. Oh, challenge? Let me challenge this guy.
All right. Here's a simple challenge. Try to strike every target before this hourglass empties.
Gotcha.
Remember, hit every target within the allotted time.
Gotcha. Did I not hit it?
Okay.
Well, I need to get a full reload. Well, I got two guns, goddammit.
Alright.
Try that again.
Here's a simple challenge. Try to strike every target before this hourglass empties. Remember, hit every target
gotcha.
Within the allotted time.
I know. Yeah, see, it's the reload that takes forever.
An off day, Duncan. Ugh.
It's not an off day.
All right.
That challenge, I will
Here's
do this.
Here's a simple challenge. Try to strike
this
every
far
target
one I need to take
before
care
this
of.
Hourglass empties. Remember, hit every target within the allotted time.
Come on, get the fuck out of my way. $350. Woohoo! Now, complete Rogers shooting challenge. Okay. Let's try this. Oh, cutscene, huh?
Duncan.
Wait, no, the other guy was Rogers.
Where are your wrist blades? I've never seen an assassin so ill-equipped.
Ah, damaged sadly beyond all repair.
So they know I'm a good shot.
Have your choice.
Where did you find all these?
I did not find them. I took them. These are souvenirs.
You would just give me souvenirs. It's nice of you. Now, these little wrist blade thingies... they work great for up-close killing, and you're not holding swords.
Custom, aye.
Duncan, will you indulge us with a demonstration of your techniques?
Sure. Well, we must. We put together a training course in anticipation of your arrival. It would be a shame to leave here without seeing you in action. Yes, of course. Well, I mean, if there is time, I would gladly, show you what I know.
Here. You see? Situations well suited to your skills.
Have a go! A blade in a crowd is always the simplest. Nothing grandiose, just quick and clean.
Gut the motherfucker.
Quite ingenious to use bales of hay for cover, don't you think?
Press left forward to enter a haystack. Oh, so they want me to stealthily kill too. Okay. And hi-ya.
God, that's see that? The spirit. Secrecy. The advantage of surprise cannot be overstated, isn't that so? Especially around a blind corner.
Whew. Move between two civilians to blend in with them. And I've shown you the blend-in thing.
Okay,
God blind me, that's a clever trick.
And no one knows.
Your aerial kills have a poetic beauty, despite their conspicuous quality. Would you show us?
Gladly. Well, I showed you the one. I got a double kill on an aerial fucking kill, but, Skewer.
Magnifique. Is it also possible to deliver a killing blow at high speed?
Of course it is. Who do you want me to kill? This guy, and you've seen me do this already.
Mon Dieu, such a powerful strike.
Fascinating. What else?
New objective, follow your hosts. Well, let's go, guys. Continue. You can use this area, I guess, to continue your,
You chose a perfect
assassination stuff.
Behind.
At great risk, I imagine. Betraying the assassins is never good for one's health.
Well, neither is drinking liquor, but I am drawn to its dangers all the same. And what is your business here, sir? Are you an associate of the governor's, or a pending acquaintance like myself?
Guns, blades, cannons, grenados... Anything that may kill a man, I am happy to provide.
A smuggler of sorts.
And how is your wife these days, Captain Rogers? Is she, here, in Havana?
I trust she's well, but I wouldn't know. I've been in Madagascar some 14 months hunting pirates.
Wow.
It took some work to dislodge the criminals there, but we managed it. In future, I hope to use these same tactics throughout the West Indies.
And how did you deal with that kind?
Very simply. Most pirates are as ignorant as apes. I merely offered them a choice. Take a pardon and return to England, penniless, but free men. Or be hanged by the neck until dead.
Oh. I imagine Nassau would be your next target.
Very astute, Duncan, indeed.
Best of luck with that.
Grandmaster Torres! Mr. Duncan Walpole has arrived.
Sup, old man?
You were expected 1 week ago.
Apologies, Governor. My ship was set upon by pirates. We were scuttled. I arrived only yesterday.
Unfortunate. Forgive my caution, but were you able to salvage from these pirates the items you promised me?
Yes, sir. I was.
Incredible.
Huh.
The assassins have more resources than I had imagined, but... not nearly enough to deter us. It is a pleasure to meet you at last, Duncan. You are most welcome. Come, gentlemen. We have much to discuss.
So what was that little glass cube? They explained. Of course, I need a refresher on it. Kind of forgot my
convened
own.
Convened at last, and in such continental company.
Forgot on my own.
England, France, Spain, citizens of sad and corrupted empires. But you are Templars now, the secret and true legislatures of the world. Please, hold out your hands. Mark and remember our purpose. To guide all wayward souls till they've reached a quiet road. To guide all wayward desire till impassioned hearts
we
are
get
cool.
Rings?
To guide all wayward minds to safe and sober thought.
It doesn't fit, sir.
By the Father of Understanding's light, let our work now begin. Decades ago, the Council entrusted me with the task of locating in these West Indies a forgotten place our precursors once called the Observatory. See here. Look upon these images and commit them to memory. They tell a very old and important story. For 2 decades now, I have endeavored to locate this Observatory, a place rumored to contain a tool of incredible utility and power. It houses a kind of armillary sphere, if you like. A device that would grant us the power to locate and monitor every man and woman on Earth, whatever their location. Only imagine what it would mean to have such a power. With this device, there would be no secrets among men. No lies, no trickery. Only justice, pure justice. This is the Observatory's promise, and we must take it for our own.
Do we know its whereabouts?
We will soon, for in our custody is the one man who does, a man named Roberts, once called a sage.
It has been 45 years since anyone has seen a true sage. Can you be sure this one is authentic?
We are confident he is.
The assassins will come for him.
Hmm, so we're looking for Cerebro. Okay.
Indeed they will, but thanks to Duncan and the information he has delivered, the assassins won't be a problem for much longer. All will be made clear tomorrow, gentlemen, when you meet the sage for yourselves. Until then, let us drink.
Damn right.
Let us find the observatory together. For with its power, kings will fall, clergy will cower, and the hearts and minds of the world will be ours.
If you can make kings and clergy fucking bow down to you, whew. Pickpocket all Templars. I never even thought to do that. Son of a bitch. That's brilliant. I never thought to do that. Can I replay this mission? I'll gladly do that. I like this mission. Not bad. Thank you for the feedback. I want to redo this mission. View the details. Zoom out? Well. How many sequences are there? I have no idea. Sequence 2, we only have a third. That's a big chunk of shit right in there. Oh, wait a minute. Sequence 1, Sequence 2, Assassin Contracts, Major Locations, Secondary Locations, Side Activities, Viewpoints, only 6%, I think, in the entire fucking game. So, just imagine, I have, what, 5 or so here in Havana? Got all 3 in Cape Bonavista, which is nice. Havana, 3 out of 8. Damn, I want to redo that and pick their pockets while we're standing at the war table. War table. What am I playing, Dragon Age Inquisition?
Rest well, Duncan. Tomorrow the treasure fleet arrives, and with it, your reward. After which we will discuss further schemes.
I look forward to it.
Excelente. Meet me down at the docks first thing tomorrow morning.
Gotcha. Damn, I was going to try to pick a pocket right there.
Governor Torres requests your presence at the docks near the Castillo. First thing tomorrow morning.
I gotcha. $500. Wait a minute. A courier. Let's tackle him this time and use the circle button. Come here, you son of a bitch. Oh, he's quick. God damn, is he quick.
He's a pirate! Run! Call the watch!
Tackle. Smoke bombs full, bullets. That's right. Hey, look, there's a waypoint here. No! Don't be running after me like that. Come on, guys. Let's talk this through. Not good for talk. Get up! Get up! 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 Shit! 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 Are they climbing? I don't know, but they better not. Where? Oh, it's right there. Okay, I was heading the right direction. I love it, like, half running up the fucking wall. Alright, so right now, I guess, I don't have a shitbox full of time. I'm gonna try to get as many of these viewpoints as I can. Telling you, for watching this game for plot, it's not gonna be a good, bit of viewing. But for a lot of- look at the fucking courier down there, still writhing in pain. Nobody looking? Assassinate. Okay, then. Now, there's another... Shit! There's one back this way. Ah, fuck, but along the way, there's... Save pirates and gain crew. I don't think that's something, that I can absolutely do right now. No, I don't know. I'll think about that later. But I need to gain access to this inaccessible place. Oh, low in the weeds here. Oh, fuck, couple of guards. I don't know, run up that scaffolding. Oh shit, no, sorry guys. Sorry, I wanted to get up here. Totally wrong of me. Totally wrong. Wait a minute. No, goddammit! Up the ladder. There's a ladder right there. Can we... Oh, you fuck you. No. Holy shit. Okay, attracted way too much attention. Oh. That ain't gonna fool them. Oh, boy. Lot of guys chasing me right now. Lot of guys. Let's just take to the sky, huh? When in doubt, just try to climb your way up. Warning, restricted area. Everywhere you go is restricted. Shit, see, they're climbing. I wanted to climb up that bit of a scaffold. Hey, guys. Run, bitch, run! Run!
Maldición! Soy pacifista!
See, it looks like there's a ladder right here that I want to climb. That's what I wanted to do a long time ago. Goddammit, game. Yeah, there's a chest up here. So that's fun. But I'm in a restricted area, mind you. Might have to kill some guys. I don't care about that. It's not quite Metal Gear where it's like, don't kill people and be stealth. It's just, do what you gotta do. And then go on get. Huh, I thought there was a guy like right here. Oh well, there's a chest here. Hey, open the- no. Loot. Loot, I say. There you go. There we go. Well, this guy's athletic as a motherfucker. Oh, you didn't see shit. You did not see shit. You thought you did. And I don't blame you for thinking. Death from above. And his lantern goes tumbling down. Oh, pick his pocket before he falls away. There we go. Well, that was fun. So many ways to kill people. That's what they should call this game. Assassin's Creed 4, so many ways to kill people, except now you're pirates. Synchronize and get the viewpoint. Such a beautiful game. Like I said, the fact that it's pirates, that's really the hook point for me. Mike, will you ever play any other Assassin's Creed games? Great question. I mean, I know Unity and Syndicate are some of the newer ones. Newer than this, at least. Fragment, and that is... Do they say? Do they tell me? Oh, shit. Look at that guy. Douchebag. Well, there's a fragment and a chest within this area. So, well, we're close to this fragment, and since we're in the area, we may as well try to get the fucker, right? Guy's back turn?
Yeah.
Indeed it is. I swear to Christ, he looked right at me. What's up, buddy? There's the wrist blade going into action. Which, that's kind of a better deal. Let me go smoke bombs. Come on, jump up there. Come on. Okay. Got that, and there was one more thing, a chest somewhere south of me. Does this thing even have, like, a compass, or is that compass north? I would assume. So, now I'm looking south? Yes, okay. So yeah, on the little radar, you can see at the very top edge, there's that white triangle. That must be compass north. That's my best guess. It's not aiming towards my,
Alto!
Hey, buddy. Oh, death. And stab to the neck and you're dead. See, the combat is not entirely difficult in this game, I don't think. When you get ganged up on, yeah, I mean, that's gonna make a huge difference when you're outnumbered. Now, the chest. Mark him. There's another guy back that way. Oh, there's plants to jump down right into. You thought you saw something. You're not sure though. Oh, but you're gonna come look. Some guys will wait. Come on. You thought you saw something. You're not sure though. Oh, but you're gonna come look. Some guys will wait. Come on. Well, I wonder what's over here. Not much, just death. 15 bucks, you cheap asshole. This guy hasn't moved a fucking. You deserve to die. Yeah, I mean, this game is just, there's a lot of killing. Not an incredibly bloody game, but there's a lot of killing. And, booyah! 317 bucks. That's good. Now, where are we at? And, what is this? This is the general store. Don't need it. I do need to get that one. I'm trying to think which one's, You know, let me just try to get this one first. It's just to the north of me. I mean, that's a long way north, but you get the idea. That one that's kind of in the southeast corner of the beach, like, that's, you know. Okay, get out of the restricted area, because now it doesn't matter. The only way, like I said, running on rooftops and, like, if you're running like this and you, bam, slam into a guard, then they'll take that as, like, a threat and try to hunt you down. But otherwise, you can run through the streets while pickpocketing in front of them also, yeah. But it's not as if, oh my god, there's enemies, I need to watch my step. Well, you kind of do, but, I mean, you could just be running. No big deal, they're not going to stop you for just running unless you're in a restricted area. Oh, pirates need help. Let's get close to this. Ah, oh, no. Don't run into the wall. Over the wall here. Yeah! Death from above. Even glitched me over a little bit. Slice. Yeah.
Pulled me from the deep there, Captain. Jack thanks you hardy.
Pulled you from the deep? Oh, you were drowning, huh? He's got 14 bucks. I don't always loot the corpses. But I mean, early on, like I said, you got no fucking money. I mean, I got 5,800 right now. With that added 12, I have 5,824. Grand scheme of things, really not a lot. It's really not a lot. Now I need to get up here where there's guards walking right by. Maybe around the corners there a better way up? There might be. Oh, the little porthole right there. Nice. Jump up here. Okay, let's scale around. Get into that one. There we go. Run up the wall a little bit. Shit. So athletic. Oh, is that a fragment sitting right here? Wow, I almost walked away from this thing. I didn't really notice it. So then let's shimmy all the way around and we'll get, onto the viewpoint, pull our way up, and synchronize. I kind of like it. It's near sundown. I don't think time of day changes just random running around like this. I think this is like mission specific. You know, I'm supposed to meet the governor at the docks first thing in the morning. I think this is first thing in the morning. So, just to be a little concise on that. Now, wow, way up here there's one. And there's a shanty. The shanties are kind of fun. It's just a weird little quirk, and that takes a little bit of time. I know we have, like, the merchant's ship that we sailed in on. But that's not even it. I mean, when the game really gets rolling, believe me, you're gonna be digging just how fucking exciting the ships can be. Loot this, no one's gonna say otherwise. A silver cross worth 90. A porcelain teapot. So these chests have more than just money in them. I mean, those extra things, they don't do anything. It just... Let me drop. Excuse me, sorry. I don't need to be running around the rooftops just yet. Or do I? So what you, girl? Okay, people notice me. I better get off the roof. And you can kind of see that little meter that's over there. That yellow circle that was just above my head. That's kind of their, it's kind of how they're looking at shit. If it's yellow, they're questioning and they might run and look at it. If it's red, they're on to you. And they're gonna fucking, you know, come after you. There's a fragment nearby here. Oh, right there. What's the best way to approach this? I say run over here. Huh, nope. Maybe I was right the first time. Let me get back up to that rooftop. I'll just kind of get to the edge. Oh, way too far. Whoop, didn't make it. Climb up, come on. Oh, here we go, from this ledge to the clothesline. That's good. Hey, guys. No one saw that. See, you know, I'm just trying to slowly collect things along the way as I'm getting to the viewpoints. Because to take on everything all at once, well, there's a shanty on that clothesline. Alrighty. Boop! Not only is this guy athletic, but everything that needs to run and jump across is just expert craftsmanship that does not, like, break. No, not in there! These shanties will eventually disappear as well. Ooh, and I somehow got that one. I don't know how. Oh shit, that guy's looking for me. Oh no. Nope, you don't see me. You don't see me. You don't see me. Or does he? Should I kill him? Why not? Oh, you fuck you. Hey, die, I said. Kick him off the roof. There you go. Oh, shit. Haha! I better keep climbing. Well, I need to get up to that tower, so maybe we should see about doing that right now. Not too many guys after me right now, so that's the good news. Run up the doorway here. I think I lost that guy. Well, let's climb up these areas, okay. Oh, there's a fragment nearby. Oh, right on the cross, okay. So when I get this synchronized, I'm gonna work my way over to that thing. And, bloop. And this is just to help you see where everything is on the given area that you're at. Because you don't know where there's treasure chests and fragments and all that crap, so this is a good way to try to find everything early on the map. Now, I don't want to jump all the way down. Whoa. Oh dear. Does someone see me? What's going on here? Whoop. Bit of a fall, but we're okay. Jump up there. Come on, guy. You're all powerful. Look at them just latched on like a fucking spider monkey. Jump. Jump on the... Get on the cross. Why is that guy looking... What are they looking for? Shit, there's more pirates in trouble out that way. Whoops. Well, how many viewpoints is that now? Oh, and yeah, these are fast travel locations as well, which also helps. Damn, 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 you know? What's the legend? No, that's just that. Isn't there something where I can check... my hidden blades? Smoke bombs? Or is it pausing the game shows me? Progress tracker. Seven of eight synchronizations. Well, I know there's a faster way to look up that number. Catch the courier. I don't need to. I don't think I need his equipment. Oh shit, this is going on right here. Dead, I say. Sometimes you just gotta fight a little dirty. Kick him in the balls. That's right.
Grazie. My thanks. I'm your man now, Capitano.
Italian, huh? This game is primarily English and Spaniards. I mean, there might be, you know, mixed in. Maybe there's more Italian people that I just forgot about. But grazie. I thought that was straight up Italian. Con permiso, amigo. I don't know. Heard that from a movie, don't really know what it means. Bullets full. Yeah, see, the courier, you can get your bullets refilled, your smoke bombs refilled. It's nice to get them every here and there, but it's not such a drastic need, in my opinion. Ooh, jeez, I'm getting a little short on time here. Well, there's that, wait, you know what I'll do? I will fast travel to this. Fast travel is the square button. Ooh, loading screen. Way better than Dragon Age Inquisition. Oh, wow. Havana, viewpoints. Alright, there we go. Now, since we're closer to that, we have to just head east. I can't be worrying about that shanty right now. I'm getting a little close on time here. Actually, I'm technically over the time. But this is what a lot of this game of me playing is going to be, is running around and getting all of this shit, all the check. God damn it. Helping out pirates.
I may pair roof on the rim, but I'm no rogue jack that I do swear.
Yeah.
Pull me from the deep there, Captain. Jack thanks you hardy.
I love that, where they hold the wrist. for a handshake. That's kind of a way to see up. Oh, there's no nothing up my sleeve. I kind of like that. That's a cool little deal. Not just a handshake, it's a wrist shake. Well, because the idea of the handshake was like, here's my hand, shake my hand. Like, I'm not holding a knife. Like I said, that goes way back. Fucking... could be a couple thousand years. Well, there's a chest right below me. I mean, you can see the struggles that this all, like, gives to you. Well, not so much struggles. Like, I'm playing against a clock right now. That's the whole thing. Not a speedrun by any means, it's just, you know, I gotta work today. I gotta get my ass to work and do all that stuff. And there's a shanty up there, god damn it. You know? I can't run up this? Run up this building, come on. Sometimes you're just running and jumping up shit. There we go. Oh, you almost had it, kid. You could have been a contender. And then there's a shard over there. Stop doing it now. Yeah, this one's not going to fly away on me, so let's climb up here. Oh, it's up in a tree. Okay, that's unique. Ho! Come on, jump up there. Grab the branch. Nope. What's up, buddy? Don't mind me, just working on my calisthenics. Or maybe day-night time passage does take place, because it's gotten darker out. Passage of time happens, but I don't think it's imperative, like, oh, you need to get this done within, you know, 4 days or etc. I don't think that's any bit of a deal. Now, the shanty. Oh, fucker, it came right at me. Where'd it go? It still shows on the radar, but it's moving, it's gone, I'm way offline. Fuck it. Let me get my synchronization. This to me right now is more important. There's one shanty that I absolutely love. Oh dear. Kill him. Ho ho ho. How unfortunate. Pick his pocket as his corpse is falling to the ground. Our resident Scotsman Jay is checking in. Like he usually does. With great consistency, by the way. Doing pretty good, but I'm just about to shut down right now. I gotta get this one last little thing here. Assassin's Creed 4, the Black Flag. I just love pirates, that's why I'm playing this game. I know it's a bit older, but... pirates are awesome. And I just need to get this, this fast travel location. Which also unveils the fog of war, if you will, for this general area that I'm in. Once I get this, that should save the game. And then I gotta shut down and get my ass ready for work. Otherwise, doing pretty good. Now, synchronize. Now, all 8 viewpoints should be done in Havana. Look at how beautiful that is. I love this game. Even to just fart around and do nothing specific, I love this game. Oh, you can see there's a chest over there, there's a shop there, there's a shop there, assassin contract over there. I think that's a shard, there's a shop, there's the shanty, a shard, treasure chest, a mission, a shop right below me in the plaza, treasure chest there. That's a nice spot to get these things done with. But we're good on this note where all of the... oh, yeah, if I zoom way out, this is the world map, remember. And we are just tucked in this little armpit of Havana. So, yeah, there you have it. We still got a bunch of shit to get yet, a bunch of chests and fragments. Got a shanty or some odd many to pick up. Oh, a shanty way out here over the water. That's fun. Yeah, the shanties suck because they move. It's a page. It's musical notes or whatever. It's sheet music, so... they take off in the breeze when you start chasing them down. That kind of sucks, but makes it a little sporty, I suppose. Otherwise, next time we play Assassin's Creed 4, the Black Flag. We're going to be just, I guess, clearing out Havana and all of its treasures, farting around. Like I said, it's not going to be the best live stream let's play of a game for you to watch as far as the plot goes, but just to fart around and interact a little bit, that'll be a good thing for us to do as I'm picking up fragments and chests, and because there's no plot, there's no story going on. So it's a better chance for, you know, to get a bullshit session going on back and forth. Green tea, I gotta get that thing. Ooh, there we go. That's looking good. Get that all mixed up and ready for work. But before I do close out, got my super duper ultra clean filtered purified water that I get from Whole Foods. A little splash of lemon juice in there. That's why the discoloration. But cheers to all the gamer guys and girls out there. Oh, yeah. Good stuff. So yeah, next time we play the live stream let's play of Assassin's Creed 4, the Black Flag, we're going to be clearing out Havana through most of what it offers us. Like I said, we got all the viewpoints done. I'm kind of thankful for that. Helps us to see all the surrounding area, which is, I think that's one of the more key points to get. Like I said, picking up things along the way is a good thing to do. If you're going to play it this way, like I said, I might 100% this game. I don't know what that all entails, but clearing out every area, finding all the chests and the fragments and all that shit. The treasure maps, I did not have fully cleared out when I was playing back on the 360. And granted, I didn't finish the game, but I was kind of just not paying attention to the treasure maps. So that might be something that I focus more on as I play here on the PS4. But I got to get rolling, get my ass to work. If it's 10 a.m. Eastern time for me right now, give it about 10 hours, 8 p.m. Eastern, and I'll have something else going. Don't know what exactly, but it just might be this. Who knows? But MJ signing out for now. Hey, thanks so much, everybody. Till we meet again. And as usual, I'll catch your ass down the road.